jongen.
Daar zijn we dan. In de Princess Anne. In feite sta je nu in jouw antwoord. Dat is een beetje gek. Je weet ook waar we zijn nu ongeveer, hè?
In Calais. Dat ligt in Frankrijk.
In Calais in Frankrijk. En we gaan over naar...
Dover.
Naar Dover. Helemaal goed. De ruimte ook nog eens een keer. Dat gaan we ook trouwens even doen met een flinke snelheid. 100 km per uur. Dat je het even weet.
Ja. Maar nou vraag ik me af, hoe bestuur je zo'n ding nou?
Ja. En dat is een hele goede vraag, want hovercraft, het hoveren, betekent eigenlijk zweven. Hij zweeft boven de grond. Dus je kan niet sturen met een roer. Er moet dus iets anders zijn.
Waarom doet hij dat?
What do you do then?
Because it's a speed that we do and for the balance of the vessel.
Ah ja. Die won't shake and go.
Won't shake a bit and it stops bumping into other vehicles.
Do you know where we can find the captain?
He's outside expecting the skirts.
Hello? Sir?
Hi.
Hi. Dutch Television, you must be the captain of the ship.
I'm Linton Heatley, I'm your pilot today.
Pilot?
Pilot.
No, but this is a ship. A ship you call
it's like an airplane.
Okay, it's like an airplane. We call it a pilot. Oh, well, this is Niels.
Niels, hi.
And you know, he's got a question for you.
Who steer in hovercraft?
How do you steer a hovercraft?
You steer in hovercraft like an airplane, but I'll show you that later. Yeah. First of all, we'll do an inspection.
Okay, can we come to you? Okay, great.
Yeah, come with me. We're looking at the skirt. And just checking that the skirt is intact.
Yeah.
Yes. And there is, and just checking there is no damage to the skirt.
It's like a curtain of rubber.
It's like a curtain of rubber.
It is not like a cushion, is it?
It's no. It's just a. It's a lot of air held together by this skirt down here. Here we are on top of the hovercraft. Here we have four propellers, and two rudders at the back. Because the hovercraft isn't like a ship. A ship has a rudder in the water that turns it. Yeah. But here, the pylons and the rudders turn to steer it.
And what are the pylons?
The pylons are these things that hold the propeller in the air. Now, we're going to check the propellers, yes, to make sure that they haven't been damaged by maybe a seagull. And now the next propeller, check that it hasn't been damaged.
Is it good?
That's good.
Waarom is het gat er?
Why is the hole?
The hole is there because the air for the cushion comes from the roof and it goes down there. It is sucked down there and blown out into the skirt.
Yeah.
Very important part of this.
Very important.
Okay.
Before we go, you have to know how to steer the hovercraft.
That's his question, yes.
So I can steer with the rudder pedals.
Yeah.
Yes. That by pushing my right foot forward, the pylons are turning the hovercraft like that, and the other way like this. You can see the pylons turning. If I want to move the hovercraft just to the left or just to the right, Niels, I move my hands just to the left or just to the right. Yeah. Have you got that?
With the propellers,
yes,
you not only make speed, but also the direction.
That's correct. And the propellers are linked to the lift fan to give us air into the cushion.
Oh, they do three things.
Three things.
Lift up, speed, and direction.
Yep.
And the rudders at the end?
They turn the hovercraft.
Okay.
All right, off we go. We're going very fast. The reason is because you're up very high. If you were sitting down in the passenger cabin, near to the water, near to the waves, you'd see the waves going past very, very quickly. But up here, you are away from the waves. But we are still doing 105 kilometers per hour.
Kan je ook varen als er hoge golven zijn?
Yes, we can fly up to wave heights of 3.5 meters. We can do it by taking the craft, the hovercraft, just a little bit more slowly than we are going today.
Yeah.
And if we see any rogue waves, any big waves, we pull back on the control column like this, and look, more air is going into the cushion, lifting us up over the waves and reducing our speed just a little bit more.
Oh yeah.
Nils?
Yeah?
Would you like to steer the hovercraft?
Yeah.
All right.
The hovercraft will steer it?
Yeah.
Is that possible?
Yeah, you can steer it. All right.
Wow.
You sit in that seat.
Wow. Daar is Andy, onze piloot Nils. En die bestuurt, je gelooft het niet, maar het is echt zo. Hij bestuurt op dit moment gewoon in zijn eentje de grootste hovercraft ter wereld. Het is toch, hè? Hoe voelt het nou, Nils?
Heel mooi.
Goed, hè?
Ja.
He's steering now.
Yeah.
Oh, it's off.
Starts tomorrow.
School starts. Het is misschien wel duidelijk. Inmiddels zijn we over in Dover en het is ook avond geworden. Want ja, wat is er aan de hand? Ik dacht eigenlijk, onze Nils heeft het antwoord. Sterker nog, hij heeft ook nog zelfs mogen sturen in de hovercraft. Maar wat is het geval? Hij is nog steeds niet tevreden. Nee. Vertel maar even, Niels.
Nee, want ik wil graag weten hoe dat nou zit met die lucht. En ik wil graag weten hoe die onderkant eruit ziet.
Hoe die onderkant er nou uitziet. Ja, en wij zijn pas tevreden als hij tevreden is. Dus wij hebben het volgende even geregeld. So now we can go underneath the hovercraft.
Yeah. Yeah, and Niels, you come and look at these big bits of rubber here. Can you see these? Yeah. These big bits of rubber here called the skirt. And can you look up very closely up there? You can see a lot of small holes. Yeah. That's where the air comes down around the side of the skirt, through those fingers, into this big area here called the finger. And the finger helps blast the air underneath the hovercraft, and it traps all the air in this area here.
Now, ja, ik weet het ook niet meer. Ik bedoel, nog meer wensen? Nog meer verlangens?
Nee, ik ben tevreden.
Nu ben je echt tevreden?
Ja.
Oké.